Happy morning, students. So today we start with a new chapter, How do organisms reproduce? So in your NCERT textbook, chapter number 8, it denotes how do organisms reproduce. I'm sure you all ask the question when you are little. Where do babies come from? Do they grow on trees or do they sell them at hospital? Just like human babies, babies of animals like elephant, giraffe, dolphin are created by the process of reproduction. But so many kinds of animal in the world, there is no surprise, there are many ways animals reproduce. Human, elephants and lions need both male and female to produce young ones. Komodo dragon and black-tipped shark can produce a young one by a single parent. Some animals actually turns male to female and give birth to the young ones, like clownfish. The example will be clownfish, and then animals literally split into two or even break parts of its own body to form a new organisms. Each animal has a unique way of reproducing. So how do organisms reproduce? What is the term reproduce? The next generation, production of next generation or next offspring. So the topic here we're going to cover DNA, okay, then the types of reproduction, sexual and asexual, which is carried over by the flora and fauna. Introduction of reproduction. Reproduction is the integral feature of living being. It's a process by which living organisms produce new individual of the same species. It is necessary for the survival and increase in the population of species. If organisms do not produce, what happens? Their population decreases and species will become extinct. Reproduction is important of each species because this is the only way for a living being to continue his lineage. Apart from being important for a particular individual, reproduction is also important for the whole ecosystem. To balance the ecosystem, we need reproduction. Reproduction helps in maintaining a proper balance among various biotic constituents of the ecosystem. Moreover, reproduction also facilitates evolution because variation comes through reproduction over several generations. Do organisms create exact copy of themselves? Yes, because of reproduction. Reproduction is a process which helps an organism to be alive in the race. It is essential to mark their existence on this world. The organism or ape to reproduce young one exactly or at least same to the parents. The DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, molecule in the chromosomes in the nucleus is responsible for the transfer of character from the parent to the offspring. During reproduction, the reproductive cells produce two copies of the DNA which separate into two cells. The DNA copies will be similar but not identical to each other. So the new individuals have slight variation from the parents. So this is the basic for variation and evolution of new species. So if you take your family as an example, what happened? Your mama and your daddy looks different and your sisters, your siblings also look different because of the variation. Okay, so there will be the two copies of DNA, but they're identical to each other, will not be similar. Though all of us have similar organs, none of us is the same. Okay, everyone has the same heart, same kidney, same brain, but the outer morphology, by the way of the morphological look, maybe the anatomical may be the same, but morphological structure is what? Dissimilar. Eye color and blood type differ among individual humans. Difference in these traits are due to genetic difference or genetic variations. So why it is different? Why we have a different eye color and different blood group? So because of the different trait which is present in the DNA. The human gene pool carries alternative alleles that affect blood type and many other traits. Other species also have variation in the gene pools. Example, though all human beings belong to species, example, Homo sapiens, the first upright mammal, no two individuals are exactly alike. So this was the point I was explained to you before, right? Both your mama and papa was different. So no two individuals are exactly alike. Even identical twins have slight difference in the DNA. Deoxyribonucleic acid. Okay, DNA, the expansion will be deoxyribonucleic acid, which contains information for an inheritance of features from one generation to another generation. So even when the twins are identical, even when they look similar to, even though they will be the sum of the DNA modification. Apple trees are all members of one species, but the fruit produced by different trees can be red or yellow color, hard or soft. Depends upon the taste, whether it's a sweet or so, large or small. So these are all the characteristic features, which is for the apple. Okay, it's based on the apple tree. Variation. Any difference between cells, individual organisms, or group of organisms of any species caused either by genetic difference or by the effect of environmental factors on the expression of the genetic potential. So when any species is caused by genetic difference, so that will be like genetic genotypic variation. And when it is like environmental factors on the expression of the genetic potential, that refers to phenotypic variation. So variation means difference. So in your class, if you consider in your class, what happened? There is a sets of boys and girls in your class, isn't so? So all are different in the way they look. So this is variation. So here I just given one of the example is dog variation. Okay, dog. So you can see many breeds of, many varieties of dog here. So what will be the major cause of variation? First point will be mutation. Mutation is like sudden changes occur in DNA. Okay, or gene. Gene flow and sexual reproduction. DNA mutation causes genetic variation by altering the genes of individuals in a population. Gene flow leads to genetic variation as new individuals with different gene combination migrate into a population. So this will be the major cause of variation. What is the type of variation? So continuous variation and discontinuous variation are the type of variation. So they are different characteristics with many intermediates in between. Like example, height, weight, skin color. So this indicates that continuous variation. They are different characteristics with no intermediates in between. That is blood type, eye colors. So this is called discontinuous variation. Continuous variation is caused by different gene as well as different environment. Here, discontinuous variation, it caused only by the different genes. Importance of variation. DNA copying during reproduction is important for maintaining the body design of different organisms to survive in the existing environment. But the environment is constantly changing due to changes in temperature, climate, water levels. If organisms cannot adjust themselves to the changes in the environment, then the species will become extinct. So if the organism is adapt to the what? It's adapt to the environment, so it may be a new species come around. But if organism cannot adjust themselves to the certain environment, so that particular species will become extinct. If there are variation in some individual of a species, they may be able to survive the changes in the environment. So variation in species is necessary for the survival of different species and for the evolution of new species. Thank you.